spicy, sweet, salty, and tangy. There are four words that best describe Korean food, the one that has gained worldwide attention. And Korean food is widely accepted in Indonesia. Does that happen naturally or by design? I'm Kevin Rasumantri. Come taste the beauty only on See Indonesia. Restaurants, for me, is the beating heart of a city. A venue where good food and community intertwine. That is why I love exploring new places, from those hidden on laneways to the glitz and glam of modern restaurants. Follow me while I'm visiting the most exciting eating places around cities, only on See Indonesia. If you think that Korean food spreads around the world only by Hallyu Wave, I guess you miss one fact. The wave happened by design. Korean government launched a program named Global Handshake in 2006. South Korean government has since 2009 been heavily promoting their local cuisine internationally, with establishment of Global Handshake campaign by the Ministry of Food, Agriculture, Forestry and Fisheries. The efforts, including in making use of Korean drama as the platform. Mother Sea and Endless Love were among the first K-dramas aired in Indonesia that marked the beginning of the Korean wave or Hallyu in the country. Fast forward to 2009, when The Boys Before Flowers became a hit. But actually, the love for South Korean delicacies started in the 80s with the establishment of Mugunghwa, the first Korean supermarket that followed the South Korean business growth in Jakarta. A large number of South Korean companies then, such as Miwon, Lotte, Yongma, Hankook Tire, Samsung, LG, Kia Motors, and Hyundai have been operating and investing in Indonesia. And now, I will visit a restaurant situated in the Sudirman Central Business District, or known as SCBD, which is the heart of Jakarta's business activities. I clearly remember when the first time I went to a Korean restaurant was actually back in the, I think 20 years ago, when I was still a kid with my grandfather. It was this small and humble restaurants in Menteng. But after that, when I was in high school, I tasted another time the authenticity of Korean food in Jakarta. But now, here I am at Chan Chan with the restaurant, with the decoration. I think it's really, really nice. It's so typical Korean barbecue, but somehow it's so modern. It is chic and slick. That's the word. While I'm visiting the most exciting eating places around cities, only on See Indonesia. Follow me while I'm visiting the most exciting eating places around cities, only on See Indonesia. here I am at Chan Chan, and in front of me there is this galore of amazing array of Korean food. This is a sign when you go to a good Korean restaurants that they serve you lots of banchan as well. Good quality of meat, whether it's pork or beef. And I'm not alone because right now I'm eating with Mr. Park Sung Chan himself. Hello.
Hello.
So he's the one that the name's bear the restaurant, which is Chan Chan after his name. Jadi, this is your new place, tempat barumu ya?
Yes.
Chef Chan ya?
Yes.
Oh, you have to go ini di tengah-tengahnya SCBD.
Baru 2 bulan.
Baru 2 bulan ya? Yes. Baru 2 bulan. So, ini ada apa aja nih?
Kalau sekarang ini dua-duanya beef.
Oh, love it.
Namanya Usam Gyeop.
Usam
Gyeop.
Gyeop.
Salchisal.
Ya.
Kalau ini duanya pork.
Pork. There you go. My favorite. Ini,
pork belly,
Samgyeopsal. Pork belly, Samgyeopsal.
Boksal.
Sam, I'm so sloppy. Anyway, oke, okay, langsung dibungkus. Yeah. Sekali hap berarti ya?
Iya, sekali.
No, full. Tapi ini yang saya suka dari makanan Korea sih. Karena terasa tuh vibrant. Tekstur.
Yes.
Ada yang halus, ada yang crispy, ada yang crunchy.
Yes. Terus ada wangi mainnya.
Ada wanginya. Ini yang saya suka dari makanan Korea. And I think that's why lots of Indonesian people love Korean food because of this array of flavor and texture. Tapi, how bisa bahasa Indonesia?
Oh,
emang dari kapan?
Saya dulu ambil jurusannya bahasa Indonesia.
Oh, sastra Indonesia. Yes. Oh, dulu, di Korea?
Ya, di Korea. Terus dulu pas tahun 2016,
yeah,
saya pernah pertukaran mahasiswa.
Di mana? Di Jakarta?
Di UI.
Oh, di UI.
Di Depok.
Oh, anak UI loh. Saya se UI, guys. Oke. Okay.
Jadi habis itu balik ke Korea, lulus dan sambil kerja. Habis itu setelah jadi chef,
yeah,
ke Indonesia.
Oh, makanya memang pengen masuk ke dunia kuliner ya. You, yes, to go opening restaurant because sekarang kan nowadays if you know guys that Korean food is so popular. Not because it's trend, tapi karena memang rasanya juga mudah untuk disukain sama, yes, orang Indonesia kan. People of Indonesia love it. Yes. So, what else? Apalagi yang mesti dicoba nih?
Mesti coba itu saya sarankan muksal.
Muksal. Oke. Okay. Caranya sama ya?
Kalau muksal sebenarnya saya sarankan enggak colok apa-apa.
Oh gitu, langsung aja.
Mm-hmm.
Coba ya.
Just feel.
Oh, the feel, the texture, yes, and everything. Wah, oh, I like this principle. Agak dikit manis tipis ya, very nice.
Just like a smoke.
Smoke, ya.
Yeah. Yeah.
Berasap smoky and, yeah, and kind of sweet, yeah, like that. But do you live around this area? Tinggal di dekat sini, no?
Iya, yeah, tinggal di dekat sini.
Yeah. Oh, penasaran deh. Saya penasaran. Apa memang daerah Sudirman dan sekitarnya, the old area, memang banyak banget restoran Korea atau komunitas Korea?
Karena di sekitar di sini banyak perkantoran Korea.
Oh gitu.
Dan banyak orang Korea tinggal di sini. Dekat di Blok M,
yeah,
atau di Kemang juga banyak orang Korea.
Oh.
Jadi hampir sekitar di sini
pusatnya ya.
Iya, pusatnya.
Oh, the office dan segala macam ya.
Yes.
So I think that what makes Jakarta is very unique that we have so many rays of multicultural and multi-ethnic groups,
yes,
right? And then we as Jakartan, kita sebagai orang Jakarta, kita we enjoy all of those food offers by these people like this. Tapi memang banyak ya daerah sini ya. Blok S juga ya.
Yeah.
Blok S dekatnya Mugunghwa, situ ya.
Orang Korea banyak bicara Blok S itu Blok Seoul.
Ini lucu loh. This. Blok S is Blok Seoul. Oh. Oh, jadi memang budayanya kayak gitu ya, pulang kantor, barbecue.
Yes, karena mungkin pas kerja, pas stres,
pusing,
sambil minum.
Iya, yeah, benar, that's the best thing. Speaking of that, sambil minum, do you want to drink something?
Okay.
Mata saya really ngeliat ini, my eyes always looking on that.
I will teach the new...
This is the thing. Yeah. I like this.
So, maybe so many people already know somek is soju and beer.
Yeah.
Tapi kalau sekarang banyak yang suka kayak pemuda kayak cara minumnya seperti ini.
This is it. Oh.
Cara bikinnya soju satu.
Well, I'll take a video of this. Yeah. Ooh, nice.
Beer satu.
This is going to be viral.
Sebenarnya itu nggak begitu susah bikinnya, gampang banget, mudah hafal juga. Dan Sprite.
Ini namanya apa? Oh, ada Sprite.
Yes.
Oh, triple soda.
Yes.
Oke. Okay. Ah, makasih.
Cheers.
Oh, this is so good. Lebih light ya?
Yes.
Lebih light dan agak lebih manis karena ada Sprite-nya, yeah. Right? I'll be happy if I go back from the office and drinking this kan, and then eating all of this good barbecue things. Ini namanya apa?
Somek sak. Kalau somek itu soju
and beer. Yeah.
Dan sa itu Sprite. Jadi somek sak.
Jadi nanti begitu ada misalnya another additional will be so naik sa. That's enough. Okay. Ini apa? Anchovy. Ikan teri ya?
Iya, ikan teri.
Ikan teri emang selalu enak. Enak ikan teri.
Apalagi goreng ya?
Iya, digoreng. You can just actually eating this, munch this with the with rice and that's it.
This one is pork belly.
Iya, yeah, the pork belly. Visiting the most exciting eating places around cities only on Sea Indonesia. Follow me while I'm visiting the most exciting eating places around cities only on Sea Indonesia.
Makan lozetok kopi.
Oh my goodness. Ini nih, this is the thing that's really captured attention.
Yes.
The people of Indonesia of Korean food, like the street food especially.
Yes.
It's like tteokbokki.
This one is tteokbokki, but it's a little bit twist.
Oh. Mm.
This is like a modern.
Modern tteokbokki. Mm. Oh, this is Chan Chan's way.
Oh yes.
Ini nih ya, gayanya Chan Chan ya.
Yes. Listen, like I use with beef.
Beef, oh pakai dagingnya. Mm,
pakai dagingnya, terus yang pakai tteokbokki.
Oh, tteokbokki. Mm.
I recommendation for like this.
Oke. Okay. Mm. Terima kasih.
Sama-sama.
Favoritnya pelanggan di sini apa? Pelanggan Indonesia kalau di sini.
Dulu saya tteokbokki.
Oh iya. Mm. Bisa rame-rame soalnya ya.
Iya.
Yeah. Coba ya. So, makannya barengan ya?
Iya, makannya barengan. Mm.
Tteokbokki itu dibuat dari tepung beras kan?
Iya, tepung beras.
Rice flour. Bahkan di Indonesia ya, saking orang Indonesia suka dengan tteokbokki ya, di street foodnya, kita sampai ada di beberapa daerah, in several region, mereka bilangnya, tteokbokki itu di sebelah Korea. Ya, yeah, yeah, that's true. I mean, yes. The sauce is thick, spicy, but yeah, they don't use, of course, they don't use tteokbokki, but it's really fun food, yeah, very fun food.
And also cocok banget sama
lidah Indonesia. Setuju. Pedes, kental, terus sharingnya juga macam-macam kan, shareable. Yeah. Kalau dicancan sendiri, mayoritas tamu paling banyak lokal atau
kalau
community?
Sekarang paling banyak itu import orang Indonesia.
Oh, justru
emang Indonesia? Iya. Hmm. Dulu emang orang Korea banyak. Hmm. Mungkin kayaknya orang Indonesia penasaran.
Benar.
Makanan Korea bagaimana?
Ya, lidahnya udah lebih familiar, iya, kan? Benar.
Terus makin banyak, jadi saya juga agak...
kaget ya?
Iya, kaget.
Iya. Hmm. Karena suka gitu orang Indonesia. Apalagi di sini sekarang ada si sundubu kan? Duh, yeah. I love sundubu.
Sige juga banyak orang Indonesia yang suka. Hmm. Mungkin karena spicy, pedas,
iya,
dan little bit oily.
Ah, mm-hmm. Oily itu penting banget.
Dan ada tahu.
Oh iya.
Yeah.
Yeah. Lu familiar ya? Hmm.
Dan seafood,
iya,
kerang, dan telurnya.
Bayang. Aldo Chansway. Abis makan yang oily and everything, sundubu is just perfect ya.
Yes.
Comfortness. Nggak terlalu banyak macam-macam rasanya. The best hangover cure. Especially di CBD kan.
Yes.
Nah, what's next? What's another dish? Makanan apa lagi yang disiapin?
Next one is Korean name is,
oh my goodness,
nakji doppa.
Oh god. Wah, I love octopus. Tapi memang Korean food banyak pakai octopus.
Yes.
Oh.
Because in gurita,
yeah,
banyak yang good ingredient.
Oh.
Dalam gurita.
Gurita ya. Oh, buat kesehatan ya.
Yeah.
For health ya. Ini dimasaknya gimana cara?
Seperti digoreng, dan ya sedikit lubus biar buang apa namanya baunya.
Ya. Saya suka banget gurita. And this is a good, yeah, octopus dish, I have to say.
Kalau saya sarannya seperti ini, makan nasi dan gurita dan sayur.
That's right, the original way. Tapi apakah misalnya gitu ya, if I go to my friend's house in Korea, they will serve me all of this food, yeah, and a gesture of hospitality. Memang enak banget ya. kita itu sudah tertarik dan sudah excited dengan food culture daerah lain gitu, yes. Seperti Korea Selatan contohnya.
Jadi,
kan
yes. Jadi saya juga senang sekali kayak ikut acara seperti kasih tahu cara masaknya gitu. Saya
sering
sekali,
ya sering
karena orang Indonesia pun kalau dari awal merasa susah, tapi sebenarnya makanan Korea cara bikinnya sebenarnya tidak begitu susah.
Iya ya, benar-benar. Dan sekarang ingredients dimanapun ingredients Korea gampang banget ketemu di supermarket. I really remember even like 10 tahun lalu susah banget cari gochujang, soy sauce-nya Korea, itu susah banget. Sekarang gampang banget cari ingredients-nya Korea di sini kan.
Every market
or... ada corner-nya sendiri gitu, the whole corner. Oh, it's delicious.
Okay, this one is kegukji jeonggol.
Gimana namanya?
Kegukji jeonggol.
Jeonggol.
Itu jeonggol artinya sup. Terus kegukji itu ke itu rajungan. Sebenarnya kalau ini saya agak ganti resepnya. Kalau rajungannya, kalau tradisional itu harus direndam soy sauce, habis itu bikin sup. Tapi kalau orang Indonesia, biar saya termasukin ke bidang Indonesia, jadi saya agak twist.
Ini nggak direndam apa-apa ya?
Iya, ini nggak direndam apa-apa.
Natural sweetness dari dagingnya ya.
Ini ada lobang, cukini.
Ini.
Benar-benar.
Terima kasih banyak.
Teman minum.
Oh iya, benar. Teman minum. Atau kalau misalnya habis kena flu gitu ya.
Oh yes.
Lagi hujan. So steamy. Gini aja berarti dimakan.
Yes.
Ah, nice. You know, this is what I like from Korean food. Ini yang saya rasa Korean food tuh suka banget. Maksudnya kalian punya range of flavor-nya tuh so diverse gitu. Kita bisa makan Korea yang bold, yang thick, yang rich, tapi get smoky dari barbecue segala macam, sampai yang very simple, humble, yang kayak begini gitu. Itu ada semua, itu range-nya. Dan ini yang menurut saya menarik banget, the diverse repertoire of Korean cuisine.
Kalau ini kayak sarankan teman minum.
Oh gitu. Oh.
Ya, setuju.
Setuju.
Makan orang Korea.
Oh gitu. Oh gini. Oh gitu. Oh gantian. Yes. Oh gantian. Duh, enak banget. From the first Korean movie that I watched, Jewel at the Palace, 20 years ago, to the blossoming of K-barbecue restaurant in today's time, I have never expected that K-food can be this progressive. But what really heartwarming for me is the fact that with the rise of K-food, K-drama and everything Korean, that we see many Korean people now starting to look at Jakarta as their home, building their communities and making these cities more cosmopolitan, heterogeneous, and of course, fun to live in.